All right, today, I already finished actually yesterday with the balancing, the weight and all these things. I use one wrong word yesterday. I said that it takes me one day to clean the block. It's not cleaning, it's preparing the block actually. Because why I'm spending one day on the four cylinders or the five cylinders, in line five, in line four, all right? V8, I can spend even 2 days. It depends. So, I'm calculating washing, cleaning the area, removing the sealant from everywhere, counting the cylinders, counting the deck, clean the treads inside here, or in this case, increase the depth of the treads, okay? Carefully check everything on the block to see that it's okay, that doesn't have anything anywhere. Coolant path, oil gallery. If there is, let us say here, any pieces like what you saw earlier. Checking all the threads to see that it's okay. You don't know who opened before the engine. This block, it comes from the factory with helicoil here. I didn't install it here. And it comes also, not here, sorry, not from this side. It comes also here. No, here does have, here has helicoil. This from the factory. I didn't install this one, just to be clear, okay? Then, measuring also down the crankshaft bearing caps, okay? Do all the job. If you put all down, all these things down, yes, it takes a day to do that. It takes one day. If you are talking about a V8, it can take even 2 days. So, and I'm taking, these pistons are the pistons that we are using all the time, all right? I'm taking one by one to see if there is any imperfections, just in case. I'm measuring also the piston on the top, also here on the skirt down. I have to measure the connecting rods. The height, I'm measuring from here, then I have from the center to the center. I make all the measurements, and because I'm using all the time this piece of these connecting rods, and I'm trusting it, this does mean that it cannot be a mistake. Sometimes, let's say, it happened once that I found one connecting rod that I didn't like it. And what I did? Simply, I give it back, and I replace it with another one. I have said that before on M157. Same thing for the clearance. First, I'm counting with the tools, with the dial bore cages with the micrometers, and then I'm using the plastic cages to double check the measurements. Pistoning gap. So it takes some time to do all this. To close, to put everything together, it's something simple. To prepare the parts, to prepare the block, to prepare the piston connector, to prepare the crankshaft, to measure it, and to do all these things, this takes some time. You cannot hurry. You cannot make it in hurry, this one. You have to take your time, because if you make one mistake, you're gonna regret it. All this job what you are doing, you're gonna be for nothing. That's why I prefer to spend another extra day. I prefer to waste another one extra day than to make a mistake in any engine. It doesn't matter if it's a four cylinders, if it's a one cylinder, or if it's a V8, or if it's a V12, or it's a V10. For me personally, for my job, I'm an employee here, all right? You cannot push me to close an engine. For a very simple reason. If you push me, I'm not gonna close the engine. That's it, finish the story. Give it to somebody else to close the engine. Me personally, I have to take my time to be 100% sure on what I'm doing, and I don't delay, honestly, because I'm preparing the parts before they come, the parts. For example, for this engine, I don't have a head gasket. I don't have the crankshaft bearing cap bolts down, studs or bolts. It depends what they want to use. I don't have a seals. I don't have other things. So again, I'm going to finish for my job. I'm going to check the clearance. I'm going to see everything. And then I'm going to waiting for the parts. So I'm not delaying anything from my side. There was some cases, one, two cases, that yes, you know what? I have to delay because I have the parts, but I have to do my job here. There are also some people out there, they're saying that they are professionals. So the professionals, there are two things with professionals. There are two things, literally. One thing is that somebody will gonna give a fuck and he's gonna do his job properly, and he's gonna spend the extra day or the extra hour, or he's gonna do it properly, all right? Or the other professionals, they're gonna say, ah, let's put it in hurry, you know, let's close it in, it doesn't matter, let us say this one, let's get the money, because that's business, for example. You have to balance these two. Yes, it does make any sense to keep one engine and closing it for a month, obviously. You're not gonna spend an engine, you're not gonna spend 1 month in one engine. It doesn't make any sense, because after that you're gonna run out of business, obviously, but you're not gonna do it in an hour. I can easily, instead of doing all these things, instead of talking right now on the video and I'm showing you all these things, I can easily show you that, you know what, I can even close it yesterday. I can just get it all together, put it all together, all right? Putting there, I'm not gonna have to make a measurements writing. This is the fourth book. I have how many books there? I'm not gonna have to start to writing down, weighting everything, count, measuring everything, clearance, plastic aids, everything. I can just take it as it is, throw it in, call it a day, right? It will gonna work. How long? Don't ask me. If there is any problem, I'll never gonna know if there is any problem. That's why I take the extra time to be 100% sure that what I'm doing, it's proper, because it's my responsibility. I'm putting it together. If the machine shop, he make one mistake, let us say, on the deck here up, or on one cylinder, if the clearance are wrong, it's not, it is mistake from the machine shop, but I'm the one that he has to find it. I'm not gonna say, ah, you know what, yeah, the cylinder has run out, let us say, or let us say, it's the piston, it's rattling, because the cylinder, it's oversized, for example, it's not the correct clearance, all right? And this you find it when after 10,000 kilometers or 20,000 kilometers when the piston was rattling inside the cylinder. No, you have to see that before and you have to act accordingly. So, that's what I have to say, especially for the people that they think that I'm spending more time. Do it your way. If you think that I'm spending my time, it's okay. For me, I have a peace of mind, and like I said, when I'm sleeping at night, I don't have anything to think about it. I'm not saying, ah, do you know, did I stretch properly the bolt? Did I check the clearance? Did I fix the piston ring gap properly? Or the spark plug gap, let us say, or how's the cylinder inside? Or did I forget any pieces inside of the engine block? No, I'm not thinking any of this. That's why I'm taking my time and I'm spending another extra day for that. And I'm triple checking everything. So, this is why you're a professional, right? Otherwise, go do it in your home. Or go fix coffee, make a coffee. That's what I have to say. I have lots of things in front of me. I have to continue working. Yeah, I get also the fuel. Isaac, he brought me also the fuel today. Nice, not bad. When I finish from all these things, when I'm gonna prepare it, I need to wash it, obviously, because it's outside since yesterday. And has also the lubricant on top for to don't come rusty, the connecting rod. So all this with the fresh petrol need to be washed, the L19 with the gloves, obviously the most parts with the gloves, even the safe here, everything, making the piston gap, putting it together, number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 cylinder in a row to be ready in a nylon bag. So when I finish with the block and when they bring me the all the parts, I'll gonna start closing it. Usually I'm not putting, for example, I have the old crankshaft bearing cap bolts to get the clearance from the crankshaft main bearings. What can I do? I can see the clearance, I can count it everything, I can double check with the plastic gates at the end, all right? And I can start closing, putting, let us say, the crankshaft, putting the piston connections inside, and then standing by for the head gasket and some other stuff, all right? I'm not doing that. I like to have all the parts, to have all the gaskets. Okay, there are some exceptions sometimes, all right? And I want to do it to start from 0 to 10, let us say, from A to Z, if you like. I don't want, let us say, to put now crankshaft, crankshaft main bearings, the oil jets, the piston connecting rods, and then I'm gonna reach, let us say, at one point that I'm gonna need the head gasket and the cylinder head, and then I have to wrap it and put it behind the curtain. No, it doesn't take so much time to put these things on. It takes time to check these parts, to measure these parts. That's what I have to say. Continue. Another one, small update, just to be on the same page. And once again, I have to repeat myself again. Gentlemen, do not waste your time watching my videos. It's for the customer and for some friends of mine. also some friends that I make through YouTube. I like it. I love it. Nice. But again, it doesn't matter. Don't waste your time. If you don't want to subscribe, do not subscribe. If you don't want to click the like, do not click the like. There is no problem. I'm not a YouTuber. I'm not making money from YouTube. I don't care. I said that before. Just to be clear with everyone. Now, if you misunderstand what I'm saying, or if you come angry, that's your problem. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.